Hey guys, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I have a very important video you just need to watch that will make a huge difference in your life and mainly in your health. And I've got a ton of questions about it, and finally I just decided to sit down and make a detailed video about it so you'll have more clarity and hope for your future. Now, I'm going to basically reveal the difference between normal versus optimal testosterone levels in guys. Now, you'll discover why 99% of all blood tests that are done by doctors are incorrect and worthless. What hormones and imbalances cause a decrease in your testosterone levels, and how to make quick improvements and basically rebalance, optimize, and even fix your hormones naturally, regardless of how old you are. Now, this is especially important considering that in the past 50 to 100 years, we are producing far less testosterone than we used to. And the decline is starting earlier. In fact, in your mid-20s, and it's starting to fall faster and faster each year. However, the good news is that you can have higher testosterone levels, which can increase your muscle size and strength and muscle mass. It'll decrease your body fat, especially around the belly and the love handles. You'll have higher sex drive and harder, bigger erections. You'll have more energy and stamina. You'll have better memory and cognition. You'll obviously have much higher drive and motivation, and you'll also just decrease the aging, diseases, and cancer. And simply stated, you'll look and feel younger. And all of this, again, works at any age, young or old. And I'll also share with you my own personal experience and struggles with low testosterone when I was only 19 years old. However, before I share that interesting story with you, let's first start with what is the normal range, right? From the beginning of today's topic, what's the normal range for testosterone levels for guys? And more importantly, what's the optimal, the best, and most ideal numbers that you should have regardless of your age? Now, assuming you do a hormonal blood test and not saliva, the numbers will vary from one lab to the next, and again, US versus international. However, the basic numbers will be between 300 to 1,000 nanograms per deciliter. Unfortunately, the regular and uninformed and lazy doctor will only do a blood test for testosterone levels. And if it falls below 300, then they will diagnose you with hypogonadal, and thus you have low testosterone. A slightly more educated doctor will allow a little bit more flexibility in the range and will say that you have low testosterone if your levels are below 350, maybe even 400 nanograms per deciliter. Or basically, this is a potential concern. Let's talk about it. Of course, what time of day you do your blood test matters. How you slept, your stress levels, and other hormones all affect your results and can give you inaccurate numbers, which I'll discuss a little bit in today's video as well as future videos. So again, make sure you subscribe if you aren't already. And I'll tell you in a minute what will be the optimal levels, all right? However, let's first talk about the problem with the blood tests to begin with. As stated earlier, most blood tests are basically worthless. This is because your doctor will typically only do your total testosterone level. Maybe if you're lucky, he'll also do your free testosterone levels, which also measures your sex hormone binding globulin. Now, think of your total testosterone similar to like your total income, the amount of money you make each year, while your free testosterone levels is more like your net income, the money you get to have or keep after taxes and so forth. Thus, they are both important, right? However, your free testosterone levels, you remember, like your net profit, is more valuable because this is what's available and more biologically active. However, let's say you do a blood test, right, and your testosterone level was low or not where it should be. What's the cause of it? Well, your doctor has no idea because he didn't also check for other important hormones which all affect your testosterone levels. And these would be your estradiol. And if you test it, make sure you test the sensitive version for estradiol. And this is the most important form of estrogen, which if it's too high, causes fat gain, moodiness, depression, and gynecomastia, which are man boobs. The next hormone is dihydrotestosterone, which is also known as DHT. This is what's called like your hair loss hormone that tends to cause many of the negative effects of testosterone. If it's high, you start to go bald, and have excessive body hair. And finally, the third important hormone is cortisol. Now, this is one of the most potent stress hormones. This will cause lots of problems, such as, again, belly fat, muscle loss, high blood sugar levels, water retention, high blood pressure, and so on and so forth. It's a really bad hormone, but you need some of it to survive. If any of these hormones are high, your testosterone will be lower. Now, if they are all high, then you've got some major problems, which was my case, and I'll get to that later. On a side note, there are a few other hormones to check, such as prolactin, DHEA, progesterone, pregnenolone, thyroid, and others. These are also important, but secondary to the three I mentioned earlier. I don't want to confuse you or overwhelm you. Now, below this video in the description area, I've got two important links that you should take a look at, which will reveal how you can naturally raise your testosterone levels with simple life changes, lifestyle changes, and also help optimize these hormones with a solution that I've been using myself for over 20 years. However, don't go there just yet. Let me continue with my own personal story about all of this and why I became an endocrinology hormone doctor. Now, at the age of 19, I felt, you know, something was just off. I had a hard time building muscle and losing fat, even though I was doing all the right things. I had slightly, you know, puffy nipples. I was even starting to notice a little bit of hair loss. And again, such a young age. Obviously, none of this was good. Now, since I was already very much into the body and hormones and so forth, that's just what I liked. I went to my doctor to do a full hormone blood test. Of course, he refused at first, saying that it's not needed, right? I'm a young age, I don't need to do all this, but I was persistent and he finally gave in and we did the blood test. Well, when the results came back, I knew I was right, right? I don't remember the exact numbers since it was almost 30 years ago. However, I clearly did remember that my testosterone level was only at 350. Now, this was normal, but it was low. Remember, the range is 300 to 1,000. Mine was only 350. Estradiol, my estrogen level, was high, but it was still normal. My dihydrotestosterone level, again, was normal, but high. And there was it, right? Crystal clear why I was having all these problems. Again, the hormones are completely out of whack. Honestly, at first, I was just super excited. I was right, and I had evidence of the problem. Now I just needed to go fix it. However, the stupid doctor argued with me when I told him all this. He said, no, everything is fine. You're within the quote-unquote normal ranges. But I protested and said, okay, but none of this is in the optimal range. Besides, I'm young. I'm only 19 years old. This is as good as it's ever going to get. And guess what? This sucks. Things are only going to get worse and worse as I get older. He just kind of shrugged his shoulders, basically didn't care, and said, well, you'll deal with that later. Right now you're fine and you're healthy and young. Stop being so obsessive about things that don't matter. Well, this just pissed me off even more, right? I also felt helpless and hopeless. I was thinking, you know, why doesn't he want to help me, right? Isn't that his job? So guess what? As with anything bad in life, you know, there's also something good because that entire situation changed the trajectory and the direction in my life. This was a primary reason I decided to be an endocrinology hormone doctor. So I can fix my body and also help others. So I can give hope to those who are also struggling with these health problems, most of which are always hormone related. Remember, genetics aside, so many problems are related to hormones. Fortunately, my so-called, you know, obsessiveness, or what I call passion, turned that day into reality, and I'm fortunate and grateful enough that I get to help thousands and millions of people around the world because of the internet. And as stated earlier, I've got two very important links below in the description area that will help fix all of these hormone problems for you if you're dealing with them, regardless of your age. However, I do want to end today's topic with what should be your optimal testosterone and hormone levels. Simply stated, you want your testosterone level to be at least 600 nanograms per deciliter, and I personally prefer over 800. Remember, the range is between 300 to 1,000, so the higher end of the normal is what you want. Now, I'm almost 50, and my current level is around 900 to sometimes as high as almost 1,200 nanograms per deciliter at times. And this is all done naturally with improved lifestyle and specific supplements, herbs, and vitamins. Regardless of age, right, you want to have normal but higher testosterone levels. Lastly, and many times more importantly, you want your negative, what I call anti-testosterone hormones, to be on the lower but normal levels. This is your estradiol, your estrogen levels, your DHT, and your cortisol levels. By keeping these levels in the optimal and balanced ranges, you'll age better and help prevent many diseases and cancers. Yes, including prostate cancer. Okay, that's it for today. This is a very important topic, and it's definitely longer than I wanted, but I want it to be detailed for you because my only goal is to help give you clarity. So if you need to, watch it again so you'll get a better understanding. Please help a friend and share this video with them. And make sure you visit the links below in the description area so you'll discover exactly how you can fix and optimize your hormones naturally. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.